In this tutorial, I will take you through the process of installing MediaWiki on Linux Ubuntu 22.04 LTS. So MediaWiki is an application for creating wikis that was written in PHP and was created by the Wikimedia Foundation. Their popular project is actually the online encyclopedia Wikipedia. So let's take a look at an overview of the steps covered in this tutorial. First, I'll show you how to install Apache and PHP. Then I'll show you how to install MariaDB and create the database. Finally, I'll show you how to download and install MediaWiki, and then we'll then access the MediaWiki web admin console. So I've already set up the server, and I'm just going to SSH into this locally hosted server. So let me just type in my password and then switch to the root user. So I finally logged in, and then I'm going to run the command apt update. So this command will then go through to update the system repository. So this is kind of like a religious process that you need to make sure you do on every new installation of basically any Linux-based system. So once this is done, we'll then go through the process of installing the Apache web server. So that's done, and then I'm just going to type in the command sudo apt install apache 2. So that will then quickly go through the installation, which should take about 5 minutes or less depending on the performance of your internet connection. So I'm just going to choose to restart a couple of services, and once we get this out of the way, I'm going to issue the command systemctl enable now apache 2. And then I'll clear my screen and then run the command to install PHP and the needed extensions, as I mentioned in the introduction. So I'm just going to fast forward through this installation, but it takes about 5 minutes or so as well. So I'm going to move into the PHP directory and then open up the php.ini configuration file. So there's a couple of changes that need to be made so that MediaWiki can actually run smoothly. So I'm actually going to search for a few parameters here. I'm going to look for the file uploads parameter and just confirm that it's set to on. And I'll check the allow URL fopen parameter as well as the upload max file size parameter. So once you've made adjustments to that, you also need to check the post max size parameter. And finally, you also need to verify the memory limit. So I'm just going to increase that to 512. And then I'll also check the max execution time and increase that to 600. So I'm just going to set my time zone. So I'll just adjust this parameter as well. And once this is done, we should be able to restart the PHP FPM service. So we've gone through the php.ini configuration process, and you also need to check the status of the Apache web server and also restart it if needed. So I'm going to go through to then install the MariaDB server. So that will take about a minute or so. And once that is done, there are a couple of services that need to be restarted, and we should be able to start the MySQL secure installation script. So I'm just going to type in the command, and then it will actually ask a couple of questions that are actually designed to make the MySQL installation a bit more secure. So once that is done, I'm just going to enable or just to set the MariaDB service to start at system boot, and then I'll also check the status of the service just to ensure that it's actually set to active and running. I'll then connect into the MariaDB shell and then create a new database for the MediaWiki system. So just type in the commands as I am doing, or you can even check the video description for a link that contains all of the commands that I used in this video. So once this part is done, I'm actually going to go through to then download the MediaWiki software from the official download page. So just copy that link and then run the command. Let me just clear my screen first. So it's wget and then paste in the URL that you copied from the download link. So it will then go through to then download a zip file that contains the MediaWiki web application files. So the download can take about 5 minutes or less, and you just need to be a bit patient for the process to complete. So once the download process completes, I'm then going to install unzip, as this is the utility that I actually use to unzip that MediaWiki zip file. So I'll just issue the command apt install unzip. So once unzip is installed, I'll just check the MediaWiki file name, and then I'll just unzip that MediaWiki-1.4.1.0.zip file. So it's quickly unzipping the zip file now. And I'm just going to remove the original zip file so that I'm just left with the MediaWiki directory. So I'm going to move into that directory now, and then I'm going to create a new directory within the var www.html directory. So once that is done, I'll actually just name that directory wiki. So I'm just going to copy the MediaWiki files, all of them, to that wiki directory. So the directory I created is just the default location that Apache uses for any virtual host. So I'm going to move into the directory and list out all of the files. And as you can see, we've got all of the MediaWiki application files located in there. And then finally, I'll then issue a command to change the owner of all of those files to the www.user and group. So finally, we'll then open up a new browser window and then point the URL to the MediaWiki system. And then once the page loads, you just click on the Setup the Wiki link and then select your language. So I'm just going to click on Continue. And then that should then lead to the next step, which is actually a welcome page. So I'm just going to scroll down and then click on Continue. So you need to configure the database on this page. So I'm just going to specify the MediaWiki database name. I'm just going to configure the username here, as well as the database password that we actually specified during the database creation process. So click on Continue, and then click on Continue once again. So here you need to specify the name of your wiki. So in my case, I'm just going to call it my wiki. And then I'm going to also specify a username as well as a password for the root user, the MediaWiki root user actually. So I'm just going to specify a password now. And once this is done, you just simply need to scroll down. Actually, before that, I'm just going to specify my email address. And finally, I'll then just click on Continue. So you should see a prompt showing you the database configuration process. So you need to click on Continue, and you need to make sure that the system downloads that localsettings.php file. I'm actually going to create a new localsettings.php file and open up the file that was actually downloaded. I'll simply copy the contents of that file and then paste them into the file I created from the terminal. Then I'll also set the permissions, actually the owner of that file, to the www.data-user and group. So let me just quickly do that now. And let's see. So let me just try to do that. And it seems I made a mistake on the URL. So let me just make a correction. And I should now be able to actually log into the system. So let me just click on login, and you should be able to type in the username and password that we configured during the MediaWiki configuration process. So that's been it, guys. As you can see, we're now logged into the MediaWiki dashboard. So that's been it, guys. That's a quick look at how to install the MediaWiki system on a Linux Ubuntu 22.04 server. Please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing to the channel. And please also share this video with your peers, colleagues, and friends. I hope this tutorial has been informative, and I'd like to thank you for viewing.